5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The judgment dated 1/12/2008 passed by the High Court of Madhya Pradesh at Jabalpur Bench, Gwalior in Criminal Revision Number 314 of 2007, confirming the order dated 12/3/2007 passed by the 11th Additional Sessions Judge, Gwalior, framing charges against the appellant for the offences punishable under Sections 394 and 460 of the Indian Penal Code, and alternatively under Sections 302 and 397 IPC, along with Sections 25(1)(b)(a) and 27 of the Arms Act in ST number 156/99 is called in question in this appeal. The first information report came to be lodged against three persons alleging the offense of murder and robbery. A charge sheet was filed against seven persons, including the accused. The trial court had discharged the appellant herein initially along with four other accused. However, the said order of discharge of the appellant was recalled subsequently. The order of recalling was confirmed by the High Court. The said order of recalling came to be set aside by this court on the ground that there is no provision to review or recall the order under the Code of Criminal Procedure by the Criminal Court, Sessions Court. The earlier orders, as mentioned supra, including the order passed by this court, reveal that the initial order of discharge passed by the trial court was without reference to the supplementary charge sheet, additional charge sheet filed against the appellant, which contained ample material against the appellant to frame charges. The supplementary charge sheet also included material relating to the recovery of a pistol used for the commission of the offense by the appellant at the instance of the appellant. During the trial of the other two accused, since the appellant was discharged at an earlier point of time, an application came to be filed on behalf of the prosecution under Section 319 of the CRPC with regard to the appellant based on the material on record. The trial court, being satisfied about the existence of ample material against the appellant to proceed against him on the basis of the supplementary charge sheet, test identification parade, forensic science laboratory report and statements of witnesses recorded under Section 161 of the CRPC, as well as depositions of witnesses, issued summons to the appellant herein and thereafter proceeded to frame charges against him. As mentioned supra, the said order came to be confirmed by the High Court. We do not find any reason to interfere with the impugned orders, in as much as the trial court, by duly applying its judicial mind to the facts of the case, rightly concluded that it is a fit case to proceed against the appellant in the Sessions case. Since at an earlier point of time, the supplementary charge sheet was ignored by the trial court while discharging the appellant, there is no bar to proceed against him under Section 319 CRPC based on the supplementary charge sheet, that too when sufficient material is brought on record against him during the course of trial.